now we're in New Zealand, and we were looking for interesting foods from New Zealand, and what we came upon was probably the most incredible and remarkable gelateria we have ever seen in the world. So joining me here is Jaapo, who is the chef here, and he is basically manic and passionate about gelato. He's a combination scientist and chef, and he creates incredibly unique flavors. Some are a little bit out there, a little bit unusual, but all of them are delicious. So we've got a tasting here that we're going to do.
Which, where do we start? Because I see it's a little bit
okay. Good.
Yeah.
So the first one I'm going to try is his antipasto gelato.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
And when Michael first told me that this was antipasto, I actually thought it was an antipasto we were going to come and have.
Yeah.
But it turns out it's got, what does it have in it, Michael? It's got...
Ask the chef.
Ask the chef, Jaapo.
So it's a Pinot Gris.
Pinot Gris,
yeah,
wine.
From a very well-known New Zealand winery.
Okay.
It's called Kim Crawford, one of the best Pinot Gris. And then we have capers and olives and eggplants and courgettes.
Okay.
And capsicum.
Capers, olives, eggplant, courgettes, which in the United States we call zucchini.
Zucchini, yeah.
Capsicum, which is red pepper. So this is a gelato, guys.
I am do you sweeten the peppers and capers?
Yeah, I mean, the way we do it is...
I'm going to eat this while you talk to him.
We make a sort of a topping jam with the veggies, and we make the ice cream with the Pinot Gris. So The white part is milk, sugar, cream, Pinot Gris. And then the pieces of veggies you see inside is a combination of candied and
jam. This is like a candied olive or something here.
Yeah, almost like it looks like an eggplant, maybe.
Yeah, maybe it's an eggplant. It actually sort of tastes like... Michael's going to try it now off camera. Michael, what's your...
That's really good.
Michael. What do you think? There, we heard from the peanut gallery. It's very good, and I would say in a way it tastes like tutti frutti. If somebody gave it to you and you didn't know that it had olives and capers and things like that in it, you would never know that that was a vegetable. So we're going to go to the next one, which is some sort of a yogurt,
right? It's a plain yogurt.
Plain yogurt.
Yeah, with a brulee on top, the sugar brulee on top.
See the sugar brulee?
Yeah.
You can see that.
The big piece.
It's starting to melt, but it still looks delicious. Yeah. I'm going to try that. So that's kind of tart. So does it have a honey in it? Honey flavor?
No, or maple. You're
maple,
right.
Okay.
As we did it with some maple.
So maple yogurt. That's delicious.
Yes, maple yogurt.
Do we have to have, does the taste have to go behind the counter? Okay. Moving to the left. They are starting to melt, but we have one that's a unique New Zealand treat called the pavlova. And,
that is claimed by Australian as well.
That Australians and New Zealanders both disagree if this, but it's a classic dessert. It's basically kind of an ice cream wrapped with a meringue.
A pavlova is a meringue cooked in a different way. It has to come a little softer inside, and it goes with fruit in general. So it's common to find on New Zealand tables this white puffy meringue, soft, with strawberry, a bit of a whipped cream, cream cheese, kiwi fruit, banana. So they make platter like that. And our way of doing this flavor was to deconstruct the normal pavlova and make it into a sorbet. Mm-hmm. So we started with a kiwi fruit. So we have a kiwi fruit sorbet. Then we have our own organic strawberry. And then on top of the strawberry, we have the pavlova meringue.
I don't know if you can hear my crunching. This is a sorbet, right?
So
this is berry fruit.
There is no milk.
This is really yummy. And then the meringue on top makes it crunchy. Now we've got one melting over here on the side, which is
which is the dulce de leche.
Dulce de leche. Anybody?
One of my favorites.
Which is a caramel. In the United States, it's become very popular lately. Häagen-Dazs actually has a flavor like this. It's the caramel, which is actually the South American caramel, right? So we're going to try that.
It's milk caramel.
Mm-hmm.
So we're doing it there, and we cook it for like 15 hours.
Is it 15 hours?
14.
14.
Yeah, 14, maybe 15, it depends on how good is the heat. And it's a reduction of milk with sugar.
Yeah.
It's also known as a milk jam.
Same thing. Okay.
Now the other thing I should point out, next we're going to the classic dark chocolate. Everything here is organic as can possibly be. And the other thing that you have here is Jaapo makes basically as many of his own raw ingredients as he possibly
Correct.
Can. So why don't you explain a little bit about what goes on with the chocolate while
the chocolate
I decide
is very
to have
simple.
Dark chocolate.
To make the chocolate, we first have to make the chocolate ice cream, we first have to make the chocolate. And the chocolate is a production of cocoa butter, cocoa solid, also known as cocoa powder, and sugar. So we firstly start from the making of the chocolate, and then we move to make the chocolate ice cream. Only the way you can really add the quantity that I desire of cocoa butter and what I want. It's a longer process, of course more expensive, but then again, it's pretty hard to beat.
So, for my friend Paula, who's an absolute chocoholic and gelato crazed individual, she's going to absolutely love this. He makes all of his own ingredients to put into his own gelato. Then last on the list, we have an Italian favorite, which is tiramisu.
Correct.
So again, Jaapo makes the cake to put in the tiramisu.
Yes.
They make the mascarpone to
Correct.
Put in the tiramisu.
Same
again,
thing
the own chocolates,
yes.
As well as a couple of other flavors. So here we go.
And we don't use the marsala wine in the ice cream because for the halal people, you know, there are many friends and customers. Jaapo is a place for people that live in Auckland,
mm-hmm.
and many of them are from culture that they don't eat alcohol, they don't drink alcohol. So
what is the flavor I taste in there? Is it coffee?
It's coffee.
Okay.
And it's amazing. You actually don't miss the marsala one.
No, you don't miss it at all. It's actually delicious. And I think what we have to do is we have to give Rocky a little taste. So
and how many flavors do you make a year?
We are on a run of 20 new flavors a week for probably 1,150,000 flavors a year. That's what we're doing at the moment. All, if not 99% of them, with organic produce from New Zealand. Yeah, just giving some creativity in ice cream world.
Okay.
There you go. So that's a brief introduction to Jaapo's World of Gelato. It's right here on Queen Street in downtown Auckland, New Zealand, just up the street from the Palace Plaza Theater.
This is called the Civic Theater.
The Civic Theater, sorry. So it's right on the main street, so the next time you're in Auckland, make a point to stop in and say hi to Jaapo, and maybe he'll have a unique flavor for you. This is Changes in Longitude signing off. Bye for now.
Bye.